Hi, I'm Seb and I make stuff. And this week we're gonna try and make a crystallised snail shell. But since I only have the one shell, I think I'm gonna try and mould and cast this. Since I've never done that before, it's probably gonna fail miserably, but it's the only way to get a whole heap of different shells that we can try a few different experiments with. So let's start by grabbing out the rubber silicone mould kit and giving this whole thing a go. So since this is my first attempt and it's probably gonna fail, let's see how it turns out, shall we? So what we're gonna need for this to start is some paper or plastic cups and a bit of foam to work as our base plate. Ideally, we don't really want this to have the opening in the bottom down here, as that's gonna let a whole lot of silicone into the model. And since it doesn't sit perfectly flat, what we're gonna need is some clay. So I've got this cheap polymer clay that should do the trick. It's an oven-baked clay, and I've never tested any of this stuff before, so it might have a poor reaction to the silicone, but we're gonna give it a try. So I've got some of this polymer clay. I'm gonna do my best to kind of fill in a gap on the bottom here that won't allow any silicone to get into the actual snail shell, but we'll keep the nice shape of the model. I think I just about nailed that on the first attempt. Next up, we're gonna need a cup. Cut it down so that it's a little bit taller than your actual model, giving us plenty of space inside here for the silicone to grab hold. So we want a nice watertight seal around the edge of this, and for that we're going to be using hot glue. This has come together quite nicely for a base, but now for the part that really terrifies me, the actual pouring of the rubber. So we're going to mix this stuff up in two equal parts to get our base, but then we also want to spray this in here with a silicone surface spray to make sure that nothing sticks to our model. I don't know exactly how well this stuff's gonna work since I got it fairly cheap on Amazon, but it says it should do the trick, so let's give it a go. Firstly, I'm gonna have to do a quick test actually. And it doesn't look like it melts foam, so that's one win. These silicone rubber kits are meant to be fairly easy. You mix one part of each together. Ideally, I would have a pressure pot or a vacuum chamber to really remove all of the bubbles, but I don't have either of those and I'm not gonna fork it out for my first experiment in this realm. So we're gonna give it a go and hope for the best. So I grab out a couple of cups and pour out equal measures from part A and part B before combining the two together and giving them a good stir. Then I grab the silicone spray and give the entire thing a quick hit before pouring our silicone mix into our mold.
I think I've got the perfect amount. That was something I did not expect to get right.
Now we give it a little bit of a shake, try and help bring all of our bubbles away from the actual model and towards the top. The more I do this, the more bubbles I'm seeing rise to the top, which is a good sign. And it looks like our glue is holding. We haven't got a whole heap of silicone leaking out the side, which is nice.
5 minutes later.
We've had a massive fail. I didn't consider all of the air in the snail and the whole thing's risen to the top. I think I've got some working time. Where are my gloves? That's probably useless now. So let's try and make another, shall we? So my new idea is to attempt to fill this with something first. Maybe glue it down. Gonna try something wild here, guys. So I've put a whole heap of water inside here, which I'm going to attempt to clog up with some hot glue. I've made a real mess of things. You back in. We're
going all or nothing here, guys. Lots of lessons being learned today. Let's take a fresh cut. This did not go as planned, but since it was my first time, I expected as much of a failure as occurred. So let's hope that it sticks down this time, and when we come back to it tomorrow, we've got a half decent mold that I can try and cast.
The following day.
It's the next day, and let's see how this thing turned out. It looks pretty good to me, but this is the moment of truth. So the first layer came out great, just needing a little bit of cleanup. And at this point, I decided to go for a two-part mold, so I had the ability to fill in the bottom of the snail shell and not always leave us with a flat base. So I wrapped the original mold in some tape, put it back in the original cup to hold everything in the right order, gave it a hit with our spray, and mixed up a new batch of silicone. Before pouring this in, I added a little chimney using a skewer. You'll see why a little bit later on.
It's a day later, and it's time to see if this worked. There we have our messy top piece. That's worked perfectly.
And now it's time to see if we can remove this original snail to get this mold ready for a pour.
I am stoked with how this has come together, but we need to do a test. And since I don't want to wait all night for resin to cure, what we're going to do first is a test using plaster of Paris. This stuff will set much quicker and should give us a rough idea as to how this mold ends up looking.
So we pour it in, give it a little bit of a squeeze and shake to get rid of any excess bubbles, and right here you see that chimney coming in handy to get rid of any excess.
2 hours later.
Let's do this. She's had a few hours to dry. Moment of truth. All right, it's a little bit weak because it is plaster. That came out great. A couple of little air bubbles, but that's all right. We can tweak those up later.
All in all, this has worked beautifully. Look at that spiral.
Let's see how the resin goes. Now, similarly to the silicone, we're going to be mixing these in a 1-to-1. That's way too much, but it's too late now. Now, I'm gonna just test this out because I haven't used it in the past, a little bit of dye. We've also got some bits and pieces of plaster in here because I clearly didn't clean out this cup properly.
And I'll add in a little bit of gold glitter before pouring this into our mold.
All right, so it's day 3 of this build, and it's time to open this up. It's had 24 hours to cure, and I'm curious to see how it turned out. Oh no, there wasn't enough resin. How did that happen? So it looks like there's a bubble caught in here that hasn't quite formed right. Peel that excess away.
A lot of bubbles have risen to the top as well.
Look, it's not terrible, but that's going to be a problem.
And this shows the advantage of making a mold. I can make as many of these as I like. So I made a few more out of resin and some more using the plaster of Paris. And then I took them outside to paint. Everything gets a grey primer. And then I just use some cheap brown acrylics to give the shells a nice natural look. by really clumping on a whole thick layer of this, it did help to fill in a lot of those gaps left by the bubbles. And after that, it was time to seal everything up before trying to grow some crystals. Now that everything's painted up, we're back in the lab, aka my kitchen. We're gonna be taking some borax and attempting to crystallize all of the snail shells that we've made so far. I've talked about this process in the past where I've made my crystal tree videos. So we're gonna be following that and trying to do the same thing on these shells. Whenever working with cleaning chemicals or doing anything that you see on the internet, make sure to use the right PPE. There are some studies that show some issues with borax. It's mostly irritation of the skin and definitely should not be consumed. But while boiling something, it's better to be safe than sorry. Now we grab our container and our shells. I'll be testing a batch without any paint and some without paint job. Once the borax is dissolved into the water, we'll be pouring that into the container and adding in our shells, making sure that they're sitting upright so that the crystals grow on top. And then leaving this overnight to cool down and hopefully form some crystals. And the next day, it looks like our crystals have formed beautifully. It's all formed around the edge of the container, as well as growing perfectly on our shells. These came out amazing. And now that we have a pile of crystallized shells, I think we need to make ourselves a snail to live inside them. And for that, I'm gonna go back to that oven bake polymer clay that we had earlier, roll ourselves out a bit of a sausage and shape it into a snail. Adding in a few eyes and making sure that the shells fit on the back before throwing it in the oven to bake. Once our slug has been baked and is nice and solid, it's time to make him up a mould of his own. So we'll glue him down to some foam board and then build up some walls using hot glue and foam board, making sure to really seal all these edges so we don't get a leak later on. Now that he's nice and secure in there, we're gonna mix up another batch of the rubber silicone, this time using a quick set variant that I found online. And time for his bath. Once all the excess rubbish is torn away, we're left with a nice mould. It just needs a little bit of cleanup where the silicone has leaked underneath. This is easy enough to do with a scalpel or safety blade. And then it's time to remove our original design and leave ourselves with a perfect mould. In addition to the quick set silicone, I also got some quick set casting resin. So after mixing this liquid together, we've only got a couple of minutes to work with it, but then it sets in around 40 minutes, leaving us with a perfect copy of our slug. So we can make a whole heap of these. Now we have an army of slugs and a huge collection of shells to pick from. Once a variety of shells are glued onto our slug bases, I'm gonna start painting all of these up. Using game ink by Vallejo to really add some pop onto these crystal shells. So I've gone with a blue variety and a purple. These inks soak in nicely to these crystals and they also help to seal the whole thing up, preventing the borax from going white with time. And since the molds kind of messed up the eye nodules a little bit, we're gonna use a little bit of green stuff putty to fix these up, before repainting all of these bodies in another layer of grey. Then adding in another layer of a gloss varnish over these shells, just to really help seal it up and give it a shine. Off camera, I painted some of the bodies of the snails in some different browns to give us some more variety, and then decided to bring in some UV resin to really give them that slimy, clear extra layer that really evokes slugs to me. So I dabbed this all over their bodies in quite an excessive amount, allowed it to drip over around the edges, and then came in with a UV torch to cure this resin. Make sure you're in a well-ventilated area and wearing a mask for this, as this puts off quite a bit of fumes. But ultimately, we are left with some super slimy looking crystallized snails, and I couldn't be happier with how they turned out. It was also awesome to be able to learn how to make some moulds, which I have a lot of plans for in future builds. I also love the idea that these can be thrown down on my gaming table as some kind of gargantuan monster. And seeing as we have a few different varieties, it means that we can put them down in a whole heap of different environments, giving us even more use out of this build. They're also just really cool to have on the shelf as some kind of goblin-y, witch-core looking piece of decoration. Until next time, never stop making stuff. And if you're interested in seeing some more snail-related builds, check out my rideable snails that I build for Wild Beyond the Witchlight.